So far, we have completed the first two parts. Let's briefly summarize. In the first part, we introduced an algorithm for mean estimation, which involves iteratively computing an expectation. In the second part, we introduced the RM algorithm, which is simple yet useful. The mean estimation algorithm introduced in the first part is actually a special case of the RM algorithm. Next, in the third part, we will discuss stochastic gradient descent, abbreviated as SGD. This algorithm is widely used in reinforcement learning and many machine learning tasks, making it very important. We will see that SGD is also a special case of the RM algorithm. In addition, the mean estimation algorithm is a special case of SGD. Therefore, the three parts are closely related. Now let's consider the first topic. What exactly is the SGD algorithm? Let's look at the problem that the SGD algorithm aims to solve. It addresses an optimization problem. Specifically, it aims to minimize an objective function, J, which is a function of W. Here, W can be a parameter or a variable. The objective is to optimize W such that the objective function reaches its minimum. The objective function includes an expectation and a random variable. Specifically, it is the expectation of a function f, which itself is a function of w and x. Here, w is the parameter within the objective function, and x is a random variable. The expectation is taken with respect to x. Note that we do not know the probability distribution of x. Our goal is to find the optimal w that minimizes this objective function. There are multiple methods to solve this optimization problem. We will introduce three methods that are closely related to each other. The first method is gradient descent, abbreviated as GD. Since our goal is to minimize an objective function, we need to use gradient descent. If our goal were to maximize an objective function, we need to use gradient ascent. Here we consider the case of gradient descent. What is the gradient descent algorithm? Suppose the optimal solution is W star. At iteration k, we have an estimate of W star denoted as WK. At iteration k plus 1, we improve upon this WK. How to improve it? What is this term? The expectation here is the objective function JW. By calculating the gradient of JW and descending along this gradient direction, we can decrease the value of the objective function. The parameter alpha k is called the step size, controlling how fast it descends in the gradient direction. This is the gradient descent algorithm, which is very basic and simple. Since it involves expectation, there is a key point. The gradient operator outside the expectation can be moved inside. This means that the gradient of the expectation is equal to the expectation of the gradient. This is easy to see because the expectation is essentially a summation, and moving the gradient operator in and out of the summation makes no difference. To compute the expectation of the gradient, we have two potential approaches. If we have a model, that is the probability distribution, then we can compute the expectation easily. However, if we do not have a model, we have to use data. Let's look at the second approach. This leads us to batch gradient descent, abbreviated as BGD. The idea is very straightforward. Since we don't have a model, we can sample the random variable many times, say n times, and then calculate the average of these samples. This average can be used to approximate the expectation. We then use this average to replace the expectation, leading to the BGD algorithm. Although simple, BGD still has a problem. It requires many samples in each iteration for calculating WK, which may be impractical in real situations. This brings us to the third method, stochastic gradient descent, abbreviated as SGD. The SGD algorithm is very simple. WK plus 1 equals WK minus alpha K times this gradient. The key difference is that instead of using the true gradient, we use a sample xk of the random variable x to estimate the gradient. Let's summarize the three methods introduced just now. They are gradient descent, batch gradient descent, and stochastic gradient descent. In gradient descent, we use the true gradient, which is represented by this equation but is often unknown. In contrast, in the stochastic gradient descent, we use the stochastic gradient represented by this equation, which includes a random sample xk. If we compare it with the batch gradient descent, SGD is essentially setting n to 1 in batch gradient descent. In the batch gradient descent, we need to sample many times. The more samples we use, the more accurate our estimate of the expectation is. However, the problem is that we also need a lot of data. So now we simply use a single data point to estimate or replace the expectation. This approach is certainly not accurate. How inaccurate is it, and will it cause significant problems? Moreover, can SGD successfully solve the optimization problem effectively? We will analyze this in detail later.